Okay, today we have a front load washer by Electrolux. This is the EFLS210TIW. It's a compact, so it's one of the smaller ones, but it's normal in other parts of the world as far as capacity. So, you know, one time I said this is a compact washer on the channel, and somebody responded back in one of the comments and said, why did I call this, you know, compact? Over here it's king size. And he was from Australia, I believe. So, you know, it's probably big enough for us here in the States, but because the competition where, you know, one company's making one washer bigger than the other, you know, this one kind of gets left behind. But honestly, I think that this will do probably 90% of what I wash at my house. And people I've sold it to don't complain about or wish that they had a bigger washing machine. So let's kind of take a look at the specs on this thing. I brought it up here. Let me look. It's 2.4 cubic feet. Electrolux compact washer with IQ Touch. And let's see if there's any other features about this thing that we need to look up. Perfect steam. It does have a steam. It does have sanitation, Energy Star, eco-friendly. Perfect balance system, second floor guarantee. So that's nice. I've sold some of these upstairs, not this particular model, but other models that the floor started shaking really bad. Platinum Star limited warranty. I'm not sure what that is. Somebody can look that up. Delay start. 1400 RPMs, which is crazy. It also talks about it being quiet. So yesterday, or the past couple of loads we've been doing, has been the overload test, right? Why not try it on this one? Let's see if we can fit all the clothes that we've been washing. Now, that's part of it there, and there's some on the floor. And we're going to see if we can make everything fit. I don't think we can, but we'll give it a shot. So I'm going to get zoomed in over here and see if we can get this thing loaded. All right, so let's start off with some jeans. We're not going to use any soap. And I'm going to stay kind of close by the washer if it starts trying to destroy itself because it's overloaded. I'm going to stop it right away. This is a $1,000 washer. I don't want to ruin it. Start loading the very back of it. Okay, so let me push down. And we may not be able to get the fourth pair of jeans in here, or the fifth, actually. This is what I'm left with right here. This. And this. I don't think I can get the door to close. Okay. If we tried really hard, you can probably get this one in. But so this is, you know, on the 4.6 cubic foot, GE, everything fit just nice. Only thing that wouldn't fit in this washer is this. We got the glass to worry about. So it may not, and you know what? Okay. I'll leave that out. Okay. So the only thing that didn't fit was this right here. And maybe we'll try to make it fit. If the water kind of pushes everything down and starts washing, then I may try to squeeze it in. So let's go ahead and select our cycle. First thing I'm going to do is power it up. Okay. So it's normal. I think we're okay there. Spin is high. Let's not be too rough with this machine. Just kind of crank it down. Okay, so we're going to go to medium. I think that's about it. Just so you can kind of see what we did there. We do have medium spin, and then the normal cycle selected over here. And the start, I think, is over here. Okay, I'm going to try and adjust the camera down. So I kind of see a problem already. Looks like the door's trying to pop open, even though it's locked. Yeah. The door's wobbling around a little bit. Let's see if it goes down. Alright guys, I'm just trying to get the tripod situated. Okay, I think we're good right there. Thank you.
Okay, so. I'm a little bit nervous, guys, with this washer. If you can look right here. Let me see. Focus correctly. The door wants to pop open, you can tell. And it might pop open. Does have a nice recirculating pump. There, 33 minutes. Not bad.
Thank you.
Okay, we're done. So remove laundry. All right. So well, now it says cycle end. Okay. Well, I mean, this washer did really well, you know, for the load that I threw in there. I mean, it was the overloaded test I've been using for all these other washers. And even though one item didn't fit, it came really close. I mean, this is the one that didn't fit, this right here. So it is a sweatshirt, you know, but I mean, you're still talking 5 pair of jeans and like 17 shirts and 2 large towels, a bunch of little hand towels. And it put to shame a lot of washers out there, just a little compact. And you know, people are right. This washer is small by measurement, but it, you know, it can handle. I mean, these washers that claim that they can wash like 5 cubic feet of clothes, you know. So, you know, man, I mean, if you sell these washers, I mean, this video here should really just kind of stick in your head, and you can show your customer this video and compare it to some of the other loads I did with the same load with a different washer, and they should be impressed. You know, I have tons of confidence in this washer. Here's some leaves. Spin dries excellent, of course. Things spun pretty fast. Probably I set the spin to medium. It could have handled the high if it wanted to. I would not recommend, you know, ever loading it the way I did. I mean, the door was trying to push out the whole time when I was washing. And but I think, you know, some of this stuff came out really clean. Even though I didn't use soap, there's just a lot of scrubbing going on. Let's take a look. I mean, okay, I pulled out those. Look at all this stuff that comes out of here. Compact washer. Yeah, right. Okay, so all this came out, plus the stuff up on top. This right here. This towel and this shirt. So, pretty impressed. If you have any questions or comments about this washer, please let me know. You know, I can try to answer those the best I can. I don't want to torture this washer anymore. It's been through a lot today. And I don't think I killed it. But I'm really impressed. You know, this washer, this is one of my favorite washers. Now, the dryer that matches this washer, it is a condensed dryer, which means it doesn't have a vent hose. It has like a condensing system, but it's 240 volts or 220 volts. So it's a lot better than the 110 volt condensing dryer. It dries about takes a little bit longer to dry than the conventional dryer, but the clothes come out really nice. They feel like they don't come out crispy or anything like that. They feel like they had fabric softener or something like that. It kind of come out real smooth. Anyway, thanks for watching. Take care, and we'll see you next time. Oh, and Happy New Year, guys. Hey, Bruce, if you're watching this video, I think you should buy one of these. And Happy New Year, buddy. Thank you.